everyone, and welcome to another Tech Talk. This episode is a special one. It's part one of two on a very relevant topic that you're all for sure confronted with on a day-to-day basis: autonomous driving. In case you don't know me yet, my name is Anna, and today our expert for autonomous driving is my colleague Lisa. Welcome.
Thank you. I appreciate being here, and I'm looking forward to talking about this important topic.
Great. Important is indeed the right way to put it. You may wonder why, because all of you are already working with other systems such as lane keeping assist and park assist systems. But where things get really interesting is when we're looking at driving functions that have a higher level of automation, right?
Absolutely. There are functions already on or about to be on the market, like a highway pilot by OEMs like Honda, BMW and Mercedes, VW. For a couple of these functions, IPG Automotive has played an important role in the development and testing process. Here's a brief glimpse into how CarMaker is being used in the testing process of the highway pilot by the VW Group. Autonomous driving is part of our day-to-day business at IPG Automotive, as in the future, more and more systems will be introduced to the market to automate our driving experience more and more.
Of course, I can imagine how much more comfortable driving becomes using these functions and automation. But I guess the really interesting part here is driving safety, because you have to be able to rely on the vehicle to 100%.
Yes, the safety aspect of the function is a crucial part. The EU has set up specific regulations to introduce autonomous driving into the European market, and how and to what extent these systems need to be tested.
Can you give us a little more detail here?
The assessment depends on the different traffic scenarios inside of the operating domain of the systems themselves. This means that a number of scenarios are being defined in which the driving system needs to perform safely. For this, it is important to define concrete criteria which help to assess the safety concept of the OEM, as well as the relevant perils and risks. Other important criteria are such which help to evaluate the validation results of the OEM, especially if the results are generated with a virtual tool chain.
What does this mean for day-to-day testing? What is the best way to test autonomous driving functions?
Autonomous driving functions are very complex functions, as they need to cover the driving task of a human driver. As such, the tests need to be more complex than the other functions that we're using nowadays. And thus, we need to use continuous integration and testing in the development process.
I reckon it's very hard to do so on the road and on proving grounds as well.
It definitely is. That's why real-world tests on their own are not sufficient anymore. They do have their advantages, like, for example, the highest realism and that the system as a whole is being tested. Therefore, there still is a need for such tests at the end of the development cycle. However, they are also very expensive, time-intensive, and you can never fully control the overall situation. All in all, real-world testing and the recording of real-world test drives are an important pillar in testing for autonomous driving functions. However, for agile software development, continuous integration in a virtual world should be established as an overall foundation in the development process.
What exactly are the recordings of real-world test drives used for?
Recordings of real-world test drives are being used on the one hand to train and test perception models. On the other hand, they're also used to replay specific scenarios to the planning functions to check if there are changes due to software updates, for example. You should but also never underestimate that such recordings can be used to recreate scenarios for closed-loop simulation.
You mentioned closed-loop simulation. What can be tested with this approach?
Basically, all systems that have a closed control loop. Normally, this includes planning functions and the motion control of the vehicle. To give you an example, we introduced into CarMaker the Apollo self-driving stack from Baidu, which offers the basic functionality to move a vehicle through an urban environment. The system under test can be extended with different sensors or sensor functions, that means the perception module. The ECU itself can be tested, of course, as a hardware component. If the hardware is not available yet, the functions can also be tested in a software test. However, there are some restrictions in this case. For example, electric failures cannot be tested without the hardware to see how the system would react in such a case.
Lisa, you just explained very different approaches to testing based fully on simulation or on the target hardware. Which is the approach that you would recommend?
I wouldn't suggest using just one test environment. They all have their advantages, but also disadvantages, depending on the development stage of the function and the specific focus of the test itself. Choosing from a viewpoint of test coverage, software-in-the-loop simulation is a preferred option. If you use idealized perception, you can scale a lot of tests cost-efficiently in the cloud or locally. This way, the function and its reactions can be tested in a lot of different situations. For perception tests, on the other hand, an open-loop replay of recorded data is the most used method, as you don't have to build up detailed virtual worlds with highly complex sensor models. The complete system with the perception and the hardware, however, is most often used in Hill, as a large number of sensors needs to be met with a powerful hardware.
Thanks, Lisa. That was a great overview. To sum it up, could you maybe explain how we at IPG Automotive proceed when choosing or setting up test environments for autonomous driving functions?
The solutions of the different OEMs and suppliers worldwide are adapted to the functions they're using, as well as the sensors included in the system, which differ. This is why IPG Automotive is helping each and every customer individually to build up a tool chain tailored to their specific use case. For this, we are using our expertise from engineering projects and the development process, our customizable hardware solutions, and our simulation software CarMaker to provide a unique solution for every customer.
Excellent. Now, if you're interested in our solutions and how we can support you on the path towards autonomous driving, feel free to contact us via email using this email address here. An AV specialist from your region will contact you directly. Lisa, thank you so much for joining us on our Tech Talk today. It was a pleasure talking to you.
And thanks for having me.
We hope you enjoyed watching our Tech Talk. See you soon.